and they had positions. And because of chief, they were losing both of them, because everybody was going after him. It was a threat. The reason why it was a threat, first, it was a threat from the political party, because of their power and their position. The Sadducees were the wealthy aristocrats of that day and time. They worked in close collaboration with the Roman government. Brothers and sisters, their aim was to ensure and to keep their difference. Oh, like today, some people do anything to keep power and position. Their lives and chief, they would do anything to keep that kind. So this is what the Pharisees were. They had heard about Jesus and they knew he was, but he didn't have it. As long as they were allowed to retain the rule of faith and government, they were quite prepared to collaborate. You see, under the Roman government, they were allowed to do things that some of the other citizens were not allowed. They had a little power and they took advantage of it. They did some things that they should not have done, and Jesus brought it to their attention.
Amen.
Do I have a witness?
Amen.
So the Sadducees saw Jesus as a responsible leader of a rebellion. And I was, maybe he's going to gather a group of citizens and overthrow Rome. But brothers and sisters, that was not the idea. And that wasn't the mission of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Before I go into the thing called our mission. Yeah. He was stealing the hearts of the people. He was turning them from evil. He was turning them from the devil to Christ. And the Sadducees were determined to get rid of him in case there should be an uprising of the people. And all ease and comfort and the authority that they had was constantly slipping away from them. Second, the Sadducees regarded as a theological intolerance. Well, unlike the Pharisees, like I said earlier, they didn't believe in the resurrection of the dead. Yeah. Now, look at it. They are confronted with God, who has been raised from the dead. Now, that presents a problem for them. Unless they can do something about it, the foundation of their power, their influence, and their teaching was slipping away from them. And they was not going to put up with that or let that happen. So brothers and sisters, they performed to destroy the evidence by doing away with that. The Sadducees, brothers and sisters, were prepared to suppress the truth. In order to maintain their place in their own influence, the priests and the Sadducees were prepared to destroy the evidence, and the evidence was right there before them that Lazarus had been raised from the dead. By the fact that Lazarus was a walking miracle, put him into a place of danger. The Jewish leader wanted to kill him as well as Jesus. By the day, on the next day, the great crowd that was coming to the feast heard that Jesus was on his way to Jerusalem.
Yeah.
Well, now look at what they did. The Bible teaches us that they took palm branches and cried out to beat him. They kept up a shout. Look what they were shouting about. They're saying, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. He who is the King of Israel.
Yeah.
Rejoice, shriek, O daughter of Zion, shout, O daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, your king is coming to you. He is just and having salvation, lowly, riding on a donkey, a goat, the foal of a donkey.
Yeah.
Well, to ride upon a donkey, says that you Middle East, it was a noble animal. Well, yes, the judge had 30 sons who rode on donkey. Ahithophel rode upon a donkey. Mephibosheth, the royal prince, the son of Saul, came to David riding on a donkey. The point is, brothers and sisters, that a king came riding upon a horse when he was intent on war. He came riding upon a donkey when he was coming in peace. Because Jesus was not for war, nor was he a conqueror. The Jews dreamed of him, thinking that he was going to raise up an army and order soldier. But brothers and sisters, Jesus is the Prince of Peace. He is the King of Liberty. As the crowd met him, they received him like a conqueror. And the sight of this tumultuous welcome sent the Jewish leaders into depth of respect.